गुड मॉर्निंग डियर चिल्ड्रन, हाउ आर यू ऑल? आई होप ऑल आर फाइन एट होम. सो इन द लास्ट प्रीवियस क्लास वी हैव स्टडीड द चैप्टर गोल्डन बलून. एक्सप्लेनेशन वॉज ओवर. सो आई होप इट इज क्लियर टू यू ऑल वॉट आई हैव टॉट यू इन द दिस चैप्टर. What were the main character in this chapter? Okay, there the main characters are the 10 shiny balloons and the golden balloon, and the third character was the clown. So there were, once again, there were 10 beautiful round balloons tied to a base in the warehouse, admiring themselves always in the mirror. Okay, while one deflated long golden balloon lay on the floor of the warehouse. The round inflated balloons asked the deflated balloon, golden balloon, what it was, and when it replied that it was a balloon, they teased it and laughed at it. The golden balloon was very sad because all the 10 balloons were laughing at the golden balloon. So after that, one clown entered the warehouse and took all the round balloons in one hand, and in another hand he took the golden balloon which was lying on the floor, and he went where the birthday party was going on. He told the children at the party that he would make squads and pirates hat balloons for them, while the round balloons wondered how he would do that. The clown took out several uninflated balloons shaped like the golden one. He took some balloons from his pocket that was similar with the golden balloon, and using them made all sorts of them that the children wanted. Finally, the clown made a squad of the golden balloon and gave it to the birthday boy. He gave it to the birthday boy, the pirate leader of the day. Then the golden balloon realized that it was not only alone but also the most important and special of all the balloons. So what we have learned from the story, children? What is the moral of the story? That the theme of the story is treating others with respect and not looking down on them despite them being different from us. Means we cannot laugh, we cannot tease anyone. Okay? So that was the story. In this session, I am going to write word meanings on the board. In your notebook, in your classwork copy, you can write it, the word meaning. First, you will write lesson 4, the golden balloon. In one side, you write word. Next side, you write meaning. Okay? So, the first word is inflated. Filled with air or gas. second one is first end, meaning is tied up safely. Third one is abundant, means left behind. Fourth one is deflated. Deflated. Empty. Fifth one is pirates. People who attack and rob ships at sea. And the last one is pouch, means small bag. See children, the first word is inflated and the meaning is filled with air or gas. Second one, fast end. The meaning is tied up safely. Third one is abandoned. Abandoned. And meaning is left behind. Fourth one is deflated. That means empty. Fifth one is pirates. People who attack and rob ships at sea. And the last one is pouch. Small bag. Once again, I am showing you this. Look at here, children, and write it with a neat and clean handwriting and don't write the wrong spellings. So, children, I hope it is clear to you all word meanings. Okay, write in your notebook with a neat and clean handwriting. Don't write the wrong spellings. Okay, so moving to the exercises. Now I'm going to show the first exercise. See children, what is written there from the story? The golden balloon was different from the others because it was oblong, but all the others were round in shape. So exercise A is, in the same way, in the groups of words given below, circle the word that does not belong to the group. Means which was the odd one, we have to circle it. Look at there. What is written the first one? Up, down, front, back. And the last one is jump. So what is the odd one here? Jump. So you circle on jump. I am going to write on the blackboard. You can see it. So exercise A. What is written? Up,
down front back and the last one is so this one is the odd one so you have to make the circle with the pencil and listen children whatever the exercise I have given you to do in the textbook do it with the pencil second one is umbrella sunglasses raincoat gum boots and waterproof coat umbrella raincoat gum boots waterproof coat these all were used in the rainy season which was the odd one here sunglasses make the circle on sunglasses clear third one monday friday Wednesday, Thursday, and Sunday. Sunday is the odd one. Pick up. Fourth one. Fingers. Nails. Necklaces, ankles, and palm. Ankles is the odd one. Make it circle. Okay. See the exercise A, children here. See exercise A. Up, down, front, back, jump. Jump is the odd one. You have to make it circle. Okay. Umbrella, sunglasses. Raincoat, gum boots, waterproof coat, sunglasses. Make the circle on sunglasses. Monday, Friday, Wednesday, Thursday, Sunday. Sunday, make the circle on Sunday. Fingers, nails, knuckles, ankles, and palm. Ankles, odd one. Make it circle. Exercise A is clear to you all. Exercise B. Answer the following question briefly that I have given you on the website, school website. You can see it from there. Reference to the context, this also I have given on the website. This time we have to do read between the lines. Rest of the lesson we have not done, but in this lesson we have to do read between the lines, these two questions also. So these two questions also, it is given on the school website. You can write it in your copy, classwork copy. These answers, reference to the context, exercise B, reference to the context, and read between the line. These all you have to do in your classwork copy, starting with the word meanings. After that, you can write the question answers. Okay? Clear? Next one. Time to learn new words. This one is not there, children. Make it cross. This one also not there. B. Okay. Now we are going to start this one exercise. Time to study language. Look at here what is written here. Look at these sentence from the story. The balloon became very sad. The clown took hold two
hold of two drums and started beating them. In the first sentence, tell us something about the balloon, that is, became very sad. And in the second sentence, tells us something about the clown, that he started beating the drums. So every complete sentence contains two parts. And all of you have studied in class 3rd also, that sentence has a two parts. One part is called subject and another part is called predicate. So the subject is what or whom the sentence is about, while the predicate tells something about the subject. Okay? So here, look at some more examples. The subjects are in the color. See what is written with the color, that is subject. The building has many floors. What is the subject here? The building. Okay? In the second one, the squirrel ran up the tree. The squirrel is the subject of the sentence. He took his father to the hospital. Here, what is the subject here? He. There was a stranger standing at the door. What is the subject there? A stranger. So, in this exercise, what we have to do? We have to underline the subject in these sentences. What are the subjects in these sentences we have to underline? And for underlining, children, you can use pencil only. So children, in this exercise, you have to underline the subjects. I'm going to read the sentence. The lion chased the deer through the grass. You know what is the subject here? The lion. Underline the lion. The sky looks beautiful today. What is the subject? The sky. Have you seen my pen? You is the subject. Moving on, next page. The farmer has sown the seeds in his fields. The farmer is the subject. The football match started late. The subject will be the football match. Full. Where did she keep her glasses? She is the subject. Why has the fridge stopped working? The fridge is the subject. Tara fell off the chair and landed on the floor. Tara is the subject. The dolphin raced in front of the boat and suddenly dived into the water. The dolphin is the subject. The book with the red cover belongs to my sister. The subject is the book with the red cover. Full. Once again, I'm showing you the answers. In the first one, the lion. Second one, the sky. Third one, you. Fourth one, the farmer. Fifth one, the football match. Sixth one, she. Seventh one, the fridge. Eighth one, Tara. Ninth one, the dolphin. And the last one is the book with the red cover. So here, this exercise is over. We are going to start the punctuation. Punctuation. What is punctuation, children? Look at the sentences there. So here, read the sentences given below carefully. Hey, who are you? Shouted the balloon. Then what the reply came? I am a balloon too. It said from where it was lying on the floor. What is the difference about the words that are highlighted? You know what is the difference? They are the extract word that was spoken by the balloons.
such sentences that report the actual words spoken by someone are set off by the punctuation marks. You know what is punctuation marks? Comma, hyphen, inverted comma, question mark, exclamation mark. These all are punctuation marks. These punctuation marks are known as, which is written in the comma here, these punctuation marks are called inverted commas. We can use single inverted commas like this, single inverted comma like this, or double inverted comma like this. Okay? So, what you have to do in this exercise, children? Here are some few sentences. Insert inverted commas at the right places. You have to do only inverted commas. Inverted commas you have to put. Okay? So, the first one, where are you going, Mohan? Asks his mother. So, here inverted comma, and it will end with here after the full stop. Okay? Starting with here and ending here. Okay? In the first sentence. Do it in the book only with a pencil. Oh, mother, replied Mohan, I am going to play football. Oh, mother, will be in the inverted comma, replied Mohan, I am going to play football. Here two times you have to place the inverted comma. First here, oh, mother, will be in the inverted comma, and I am going to play football will be in the inverted comma. You can see properly. Well, then you should complete your homework before going to play, said mother. Well, then you should complete your homework before going to play. After play, till here. Okay? Starting with here and ending with here. I have already done so, mother, said Mohan as he ran towards the door. I have already done so, mother. Till here, you have to place the inverted comma. Look at here. See, starting with here and ending with here. The last one. Mother smiled and said, you are a good boy, Mohan. You have to place the inverted comma from here and end here. Once again, I am going to show this all exercises. See, children, you have to do this with the pencil in your textbook. So, children, all the exercises are over. I hope it is clear to you all. And whatever the question answers and word meanings, it is given on the school website. You can go through from there. Okay? So, that's all for today. Stay home, stay safe. I'll meet you with the next chapter in the next session. Thank you.